This presentation will cover the anatomy of the reproductive system as we prepare to discuss radiographic examinations still performed. Internal structures of the female reproductive system consist of the ovaries, the uterine tubes, the uterus, and the vagina. The ovaries, which are two small, glandular, almond-shaped organs, located one on each side near the lateral wall of the pelvis. Internal secretions control the menstrual cycle, while externally, they secrete ova, the female reproductive cell. The medulla is the core of the vascular tissue, while the cortex composes the outer glandular tissue. Each ovary contains ovarian follicles, and each follicle contains one ovum. A fully developed ovarian follicle is referred to as a Graafian follicle. Ovulation occurs with the extrusion of an ovum by rupture of a follicle. The uterine tubes, also called fallopian tubes, arise from lateral angle of the uterus on each side and open into the peritoneal cavity. They function to collect ovum released by the ovaries and convey it to the uterine cavity. Each is typically 3 to 5 inches, or 7.6 to 13 centimeters long, and can be divided into three parts, the isthmus, the ampulla, and the infundibulum. The isthmus is the short segment near the uterus. The ampulla composes the majority of the tube, and the infundibulum is the terminal lateral portion that is flared in appearance. Each fallopian tube ends in series of irregular, prolonged processes called fimbriae. The uterus is a pear-shaped muscular organ situated in the central part of the pelvic cavity, posterior to urinary bladder and anterior to the rectal ampulla. The nulliparous uterus extends approximately 3 inches or 7.6 centimeters in length. The uterus consists of four parts: the fundus, the body, the isthmus, and the cervix. The fundus is the blunt, rounded superior portion, and the body narrows superiorly from the fundus to inferior isthmus. The isthmus is the superior part of the cervix, which is a constricted area between the body and the cervix. Cervix is the cylindric vaginal end of the uterus. The vagina is attached around a circumference of cervix and is approximately 1 inch or 2.5 centimeters long. The uterine cavity appears triangular and viewed in the frontal plane, and the endometrium composes the inner mucosal lining of uterine cavity. The uterus functions to receive and retain fertilized ovum until development of fetus is complete, then expels the mature fetus during birth. The internal reproductive structures of the male include the testes, the ductus deferens, or vas deferens, the prostate gland, ejaculatory ducts, seminal vesicles, and the bulbourethral glands. The external reproductive structures of the male include the penis and the scrotum. Structures enclosed by the scrotal sac include the testes, epididymis, the spermatic cords, and part of the ductus deferens. The testes are ovoid bodies averaging 1.5 inches or 3.8 centimeters in length and 1 inch or 2.5 centimeters in width and depth. They're divided into 200 to 300 partial compartments that constitute the glandular substance. Each compartment houses one or more convoluted germ cell producing tubules, which unite into 15 to 20 ductules that exit the testes and enter the epididymis. The epididymis is an oblong structure attached to superior and lateral-posterior aspects of the testes. The main duct is continuous with the ductus deferens, which is about 16 to 18 inches long, and extends from the tail of the epididymis to the posterior surface of the urinary bladder. The ampulla is the expanded end that serves as a reservoir for seminal fluid and unites with the seminal vesicle. The seminal vesicles are approximately 2 inches or 5 centimeters long and are situated obliquely on lateral posterior surface of the bladder. The junction with the ampulla of the ductus deferens forms the ejaculatory duct. The ejaculatory ducts average 1/2 inch or 1.3 centimeters long and originate behind the neck of the bladder. The two ducts enter the base of the prostate and function to eject sperm into the urethra before ejaculation. The prostate is an accessory genital organ averaging 1.25 inches or 3.2 centimeters long and encircles the proximal portion of the urethra. It lies anterior to the rectal ampulla, and its ducts open into the prostatic portion of the urethra.